The old hometown looks the same as I step down from the train. And there to meet me is my mom.
The name Velma Barfield may not mean much to you. 51-year-old grandmother gave arsenic to her fiancé, and there's a real question. She did it to get their money. Motive is unclear. Put to death as scheduled first woman to be executed. Her choice, gas or lethal injection. Letting her live, safe in prison, sane on drugs, the killings. Fiancé. His daughter.
Saw him agony and pain. They're twisting and turning. Kind of an ash gray. Bloated.
So poisoned.
Your pain and agony, seeing him suffer. She enjoyed every minute of it.
They say she has a gentle disposition.
But to us, she's a murderer.
Spent her life in Lumberton, North Carolina. Rough childhood. Mother, who molested her. After she married, husband lost his jobs. Nervous breakdown. Pills, Valium, Tranzine, Elevil. Her children knew their mother was in trouble.
But I was just torn apart. I knew she needed the help. Halfway house. She didn't want to go.
An ant poison, a roach poison. This is the courtroom. Confessions were read to the jury. Her sentence? Execution. Turney.
Understanding her life, understanding the effect of the drugs, this is an inappropriate case for the death penalty.
Governor of North Carolina announced he would not commute the death sentence. Made his decision in the midst of his close race for the Senate against Republican Senator Jesse Helms.
She was properly evaluated, I found. I'm a person who believes in forgiveness. That doesn't necessarily mean you escape the penalty, however. Have to be punished.
And I'm going to be with my mother up until the last, until they say I can't be with her anymore.
I didn't cause this. Velma Barfield caused this.
No one is killing her. She has been executed. There's a difference in the words. She did it to herself.
I'll be wearing these pajamas today. I told the matron, don't come round here with one of them prison gowns. I don't want to meet Jesus wearing polyester. You know how it chafes so bad when you're nervous. I tried to be good. I always tried to do everything that Mama and Jesus told me to. I smiled. I had my pretty ways. Nice Velma. Shy Velma. Sweet little Velma. Oh, Jesus, keep me good. But Jesus can only do so much. One good thing about it, they're doing it the modern way, with a needle. Now that's nicer, especially for a woman. Electrocution's messy, ruins your hairdo. But a needle, now that's medication. Pump it down and bang, there's Jesus. I married Tom when I wasn't much more than a baby. Things got better. We had a house, two kids. Then he lost his job and started to drinking, and I could see where life was going to repeat itself. I was scared. I went to the doctor, and he gave me pills. He gave me Valium, Elevil, Dalmane, Cinequan, Librium, Tylenol, codeine. I got addicted so fast, it was like I always had been. I got to where only two things occupied my mind. My medication and a deep, burning shame. I needed $100 a week just to pay for those pills. Doctors gotta have their money, you know that. And a practical nurse doesn't make none to speak of. So, I stole for it. Stole from the people I was nursing. I wrote bad checks on their accounts. Now that is a dumb way to steal. When they found out, which they did right away, I thought the shame would kill me. Oh, Lord, I was burning up with shame. I don't think I really meant to kill them. I just wanted to make them a little bit sicker so I could nurse them back to health and they'd love me again. But I miscalculated the dose. It was ant poison, And a person is a lot bigger than any ant. Now, I know that I have sinned mightily in the eyes of the Lord and the state of North Carolina. But Jesus has forgiven me. He's waiting to hold me to his bosom. He knows we're all born sweet and helpless little babies into a hard and puzzling world. The state can't be so quick to forgive, but I don't blame the governor. He's a nice white boy, a Christian. He might have gotten me off death row if he hadn't have been running for office. It's all over now. I told my lawyers, no more appeals. And I thank the Lord that Jesus is not a politician.
How do you get through these days? First of all, in the mornings, I get up early. And each day is a struggle and a hard day here. But I get up early every morning. I have the officer to call me before the day starts here. And I spend a time alone studying the scriptures and praying and preparing myself as best I can, asking for strength and grace for that day.
Then I awake and look around me at the gray walls that surround me, and I realize that I was only dreaming, for there's a garden and there's a sad old padre arm in arm. At daybreak again, I'll touch the green, green grass of home. Yes, there are.